we have a choice in this world about how to tell sad stories. On the one hand, you can sugarcoat it, the way they do in movies and romance novels, where beautiful people learn beautiful lessons. When nothing is too messed up that can't be fixed with an apology and a Peter Gabriel song. I like that version as much as the next girl does, believe me. It's just not the truth. This is the truth. Sorry. Late in the winter of my 17th year, my mother decided that I was depressed.
She eats like a bird. She barely leaves the house.
I'm not depressed, Mom.
She's reading the same book over and over.
She's depressed.
I'm not depressed! The booklets and the websites always list depression as a side effect of cancer. Depression's not a side effect of cancer. It's a side effect of dying. Which is what was happening to me.
I may switch you to Zoloft or Lexapro. And twice a day instead of once.
Why stop there? Really, just keep coming. Like the Keith Richards of cancer kids.
Have you been going to that support group I suggested?
Yeah, it's not my thing.
Support groups can be a great way for you to connect with people who are...
Who are... What?
On the same journey.
Journey? Really?
Give it a chance. Who knows, you might even find it enlightening.
You guys ready? We are gathered here today, literally, in the heart of Jesus. We're here with JC, who wants to share their story with the group.
I'm Angel. I have acute myeloid leukemia.
Sid, acute lymphoblastic leukemia.
Hi, I'm PJ. I have neuroblastoma.
I'm Patrick. Testicular.
I'll spare you the gory details of Patrick's bowel cancer. Basically, they found it in his guts. They cut most of it out, and he almost died, but he didn't die. So now here he is, divorced, friendless, living on his parents' couch, exploiting his cancer-tastic past in the heart of Jesus, literally, to show us that one day, if we're lucky, we could be just like him.
Next. Hazel?
I'm Hazel. A thyroid originally, but now with quite the impressive satellite colony in my lungs.
And how are you doing?
You mean besides the terminal cancer? Alright, I guess.
We're here for you, Hazel. Why don't I play another song? Christ is our friend and he'll be there till the end. Christ is our friend and he'll be there till the end.
Reality shows, doctor's appointments, 8 prescription drugs, 3 times a day, but worse of all, support group.
You cannot make me.
Of course we can. We're your parents.
Mom, you've been through this. You need to go. Make friends. Be a teenager.
Mom, if you want me to be a teenager, you don't send me to support group. You gotta, give me a fake ID so that I can go to clubs and drink gimlets and take pot.
You don't take pot.
Okay, well, that is the kind of thing I would know with a fake ID.
Can you just get in the car, please?
And so I went. Not because I wanted to or because I thought it would help me, but for the same reason I did anything these days. To make my parents happy. I really don't understand why I can't just try it myself. It's not like you're gonna do anything, you're just gonna sit here and wait again.
Of course I'm not. No, I've got stuff to do. I'm gonna do errands. I love you.
I love you too.
Have fun.
The only thing worse than fighting it from cancer. Having a kid bite it from cancer.
Hey! Make some friends.
Oh, sorry. I'll take the stairs.
No problem.
Thank you. Sorry.
What's your name?
Hazel.
And what's your full name?
Hazel Grace Lancaster.
What?
I didn't say anything.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Because you're beautiful.
Oh my god.
I enjoy looking at beautiful people. See, I decided to walk back, not to deny myself the simpler pleasures of existence, particularly as you so astutely pointed out, we're all gonna die pretty soon.
Okay, that's great, but I am not beautiful.
Hi, Lisa. I like it when you say it.
I like it when you say it.
Okay. Always.
Always? What's with the always?
Always is like a thing, like always love each other and whatnot. Always. I probably texted always to each other like 14 million times this year. Actually hurt you unless you light them. Huh? I never lit one. It's a metaphor, see? You put the thing that does the killing right between your teeth. But you never give it the power to kill you. A metaphor.
Sweetheart, is it top bottle time?
No. I've made plans for the Augustus Waters.
Yeah, I failed my test a couple times.
You don't say.
Actually, the fourth time I took the test, it was going about how this is going. And when it was over, the instructor looks over at me. And she says, "Your driving, while unpleasant, is not technically unsafe."
Cancer proof.
Total cancer proof. So, tell me about you.
I was 13 when they found it. Pretty much worst case scenario. Thyroid, stage 4. Not much they could do. Which didn't stop them, of course. Surgery, radiation, chemo, more radiation. All of which worked for a while. But then stopped working. And then one day, my lungs started filling up with water.
Nurse! We need a nurse right now!
I couldn't breathe. No one can get it under control.
You can let go, sweetie. Don't be afraid.
That should have been the end. But then something strange happened. The antibiotics kicked in, they drained the fluid from my lungs. I got some strength back. Next thing I know, I found myself in an experimental trial. You know, the ones that are famous in the Republic of Cancervania for not working? It's called phalanxifer. It didn't work in over 70% of the patients, but for some reason, it's been working for me. So they called it the miracle. Of course, my lungs still suck at being lungs, but theoretically, they could continue to suck like this for, I don't know, a while.
So are you back in school?
I got my GED, so I'm taking classes at NCC.
Whoa, a college girl! Well, that explains the aura of sophistication. Welcome to my humble abode. My folks call them encouragements. Don't ask. Hi, guys!
Hey! Augustus, hi! New friend?
Yeah, this is Hazel Grace.
Hey,
Oh, it's just Hazel.
How's it going, just Hazel?
Hi, Hazel. How are you?
Yeah, we're going downstairs. Bye.
Nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you.
Grace!
Welcome to the sweet torture of reading an imperial fiction.
But you are breaking all the rules.
Are you okay?
And now I'm breaking all the rules.
Yeah, I am excellent. I am, however, with Isaac. And Isaac, does support group Hazel make this better or worse? Isaac, come focus on me. I'm asking you, get here. Great, all right, well, the door's open, so I gotta run, bye.
Hello?
Isaac, yo, Hazel Grace from the support group's here.
Hi.
Gentle reminder. Isaac's in the midst of a psychotic episode right now.
You have eyes, by the way.
Augustus?
Yes.
What are you doing?
I may have found Van Houten's assistant, emailed her.
Augustus.
She may have forwarded that email on to Van Houten. Shall I continue?
Oh, yeah, go.
I am particularly indebted to you, sir. Hazel Grace, he just called me sir.
Augustus, keep reading.
Both for your kind words about an imperial affliction and for taking the time to tell me that the book, and here I quote you directly, meant a great deal to you and your friend Hazel Grace.
Oh, you did not.
Of course I did. To answer your question, no, I have not written anything else, nor will I. I do not feel that continuing to share my thoughts with readers would benefit either them or me. However, thank you for your generous email. Yours most sincerely, Peter Van Houten. So yeah, that just happened.
Oh my god.
I've been trying to tell you I'm kind of awesome.
Do you think that I...
Check your inbox.
Oh my god. Oh my god, Augustus. I'm freaking out.
Dear Mr. Peter Van Houten, my name is Hazel Grace Lancaster. My friend Augustus Waters, who read your book at my recommendation, just received an email from you at this address. I hope you will not mind that he shared that email with me. I was wondering if you wouldn't mind answering a few questions I have about what happens after the end of the book. Specifically the following. Does Anna's mom marry the Dutch Tulip Man? And is the Dutch Tulip Man up to something, or is he just completely misunderstood? Lastly, I was hoping you could shed some light on Sisyphus the hamster. These questions have haunted me for years, and I don't know how long I have left to get answers to them. I know that these are not important literary questions, and that your book is full of important literary questions, but I would just really like to know. And of course, if you ever do decide to write anything else, I would love to read it. Frankly, I'd read your grocery lists. Yours with great admiration, Hazel Grace Lancaster.
Not bad.
You think?
Yeah, I mean, it's a bit pretentious, but then again, Van Houten uses words like tendentious and bacchanalia, so I think you'll like it. Okay, we'll be our always.
I'm so sorry. It's okay.
a genius. Use your wish.
I already use it. Free miracle.
Would you use it on? Not Disney. Hazel Grace. You did not go to Disney World. You did not use your last dying wish to go to Disney World.
And Epcot Center.
Oh my god.
It was actually a really fun trip.
That's the saddest thing I've ever heard.
No, I'm goofy.
Now I'm just embarrassed.
Why are you embarrassed?
I can't believe I have a crush on a girl with such cliche wishes. Terrible. Lancaster.
Hey, Rick Smith's jersey?
Yeah, it is indeed.
I love that guy.
I'm Augustus Waters.
Nice to meet you, I'm Michael.
Good to see you.
Hi, Miss Lancaster. Good to see you. Hi, Hazel Grace.
Hi.
How would you like to go on a picnic with me?
I would love to go on a picnic with you. Hospital, so I should just change.
So, you're a survivor yourself.
Yeah. You know, I didn't cut this fellow off for the hell of it. Although it does make an excellent weight loss strategy. How's your health now? It's great. NEC for 14 months.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. I'm very lucky.
Hey, listen, Gus. You have to understand, Hazel's still pretty sick. And she will be the rest of her life. And she's gonna want to keep up with you. She's that kind of girl, but the truth is her lungs.
Ready, Gus?
Yeah.
See you soon.
All right.
Oh, such a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Is this where you take all of your romantic conquests?
Yeah, every last one of them. That's probably why I'm still a virgin.
You are not still a virgin. Are you really?
Let me show you something. See this circle? That is the circle of virgins.
Uh-huh.
And this is 18-year-old dudes with one leg. So yeah. Funky Bones by Jop van Lieshout.
Sounds quite Dutch.
Yes. Much like Rick Smith's. And tulips. Sandwich.
Let's make it.
Dutch cheese and tomato. Sorry, the tomatoes are Mexican.
How dare you?
How cool is this? They're using a skeleton as a playground. Think about that.
I do love your symbols.
Speaking of which, you're probably wondering why you're sitting here eating a bad cheese sandwich and drinking orange juice with a guy in a Rick Smith's jersey.
It actually has crossed my mind.
Well, Hazel Grace, like so many before you, and listen, I say this with the utmost of affection. You used your wish moronically.
Okay, we've been through this. I was 13.
Hush! I am in the midst of a grand soliloquy here. You were young, impressionable, the Grim Reaper staring you right in the face, and it led you to rush into making a wish you didn't really want. But how could little Hazel Grace, having never read an Imperial Affliction, know that her one true wish was to visit Mr. Peter Van Houten in his Amsterdam exile?
But I didn't say that, so...
It's a good thing I saved mine.
So you're saying...
I'm not going to give you my wish or anything, Hazel. If that's what you're thinking. However, you know, I too have an interest in meeting this Mr. Peter Van Houten, and I don't really think it would make much sense to meet him without the girl who introduced me to the book in the first place, now would it? So I talked to the genius, and they're all for it. We leave in a month.
Thank you.
question?
Yes, Hazel.
Can I still go to Amsterdam?
Would not be wise at this juncture.
Why not?
Is there any way we can make that trip happen?
It would increase some risks.
But so does going to the mall.
Yes, but an airplane?
But they have oxygen airplanes.
You're stage 4.
This is an opportunity that I may never get again. Ever. If the medication is working, I don't understand why.
Perhaps there's a scenario.
No. I don't know any other way to say this, Hazel. You're just too sick. I'm sorry.
Hi, Augustus.
Are you okay?
No.
What's the matter? Talk to me. To see the swing set of tears. I do see your point. This is one sad swing set. Hazel Grace, I hope you realize you're trying to keep your distance from me in no way lessens my affection for you. All your efforts to keep me from you are gonna fail.
Out with you and everything, but I can't let this go on any further.
I wouldn't mind.
No, you don't understand.
I do understand.
No, you don't.
No, I know
understand.
What you're trying to say. And Hazel, I'm saying I wouldn't mind. It'd be a privilege to have my heart broken by you. Hazel, I'm
Gus, I'm a grenade. One day I'm gonna explode, and I'm gonna obliterate everything in my wake, and I don't know, I feel like it's my responsibility to minimize the casualties.
Open.
like I said to the genies, I travel in style or I don't travel at all.
Well, we're going to Amsterdam.
We are going to Amsterdam right now.
Hello, Lancasters.
Gus. Hey, nice to see you.
Gus, you're so inventive.
Okay, Hazel Grace?
Okay.
Jackie, I'm really sorry about that.
No, it's totally fine. It's called a cannula. It helps me breathe. See this little friend right here? He feeds me oxygen through the tube.
Would it help me breathe too?
Maybe. Do you want to try it?
Okay.
Come here. There you go.
Tickles.
Well, yeah. That's something.
I think I'm breathing better.
I would love to give it to you, but I kind of could use the help.
Thanks for letting me try it.
You're welcome.
Okay, Jackie, let's go. Thank you. Okay.
Bye.
I think that's us.
That's us. We are going to Amsterdam.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
beautiful.
I'm just saying.
You're just saying. What, you're saying that you're totally fine with your teenage daughter running free with an older boy in a city that's famous for its vice and debauchery is totally fine with you? Oh, it's just because she can't speak English.
Shut up if they ask.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, remember what you said about Vegas?
Yeah.
Do you think I can join in on that deal?
God?
Maybe.
How about angels?
No.
Afterlife?
No. Well, maybe. I don't know. I guess I wouldn't go as far as to say no, but I would like some evidence. What about you?
Absolutely.
Really?
I mean, not like a heaven where you ride in a unicorn all day and live in a mansion made of clouds, but yes, I definitely believe in something. I mean, otherwise, what's the point?
Maybe there is no point.
I won't accept that. I am in love with you. You heard me. Love is just a shout into the void, and that oblivion is inevitable, and that we're all doomed, and that one day all of our labors will be returned to dust. And I know that the sun will swallow the only earth we will ever have, and I am in love with you. Sorry.
Sorry, let me
Thank you so much for running back to us.
Clearly an error in judgment. Yours are the first missives to which I replied. Look where you got me. Scotch.
Thank you.
Just me, Adelaide, am I? Another scotch and soda, please.
Perhaps some breakfast first, Peter?
She thinks I have a drinking problem.
I also think the earth is round.
Of course you do. Like all sick kids, your existence depends on it. You are fated to live
Peter!
Days, as the child you were when diagnosed, a child who believes there is a life after a novel ends. And we as adults, we pity this. So we pay for your treatments, your oxygen machines.
Peter,
you
that's
are a side effect to an evolutionary process that cares little for individual lives. You are a failed experiment in mutation.
Listen, douchebags. There's nothing that you're going to tell me about my disease that I don't already know. Okay, I came here for one thing and one thing only. That is for you to tell me what happens at the end of this goddamn book.
I can't tell you.
Bullshit.
I can't.
Make something up!
I want you to leave.
Why you care so much about your silly questions?
Go fuck yourself.
It's okay. It's okay. I'll write you a sequel. All right, I'll write you a sequel. It'll be better than any piece of shit that drunk guy could write. You'll have blood and guts and sacrifice. You'll love it.
So sorry I spent your wish on that asshole.
No, you did not spend it on him. You spent it on us.
Hazel and Augustus! I'm very sorry. The circumstances have made him cruel. I thought meeting you would help him. That he could see that his work has shaped real lives, but I'm very sorry. Perhaps we can do some sightseeing? Have you been to the Anne Frank house?
I'm not going anywhere with that man.
No. He's not invited. I'm afraid there's no elevator. That's all right. I mean, well, there are many stairs, steep staircases.
You know, Hazel, we don't have to.
I can do it. Let's go. I'll come with you then. Thank you, man. So this is the actual bookcase that hit the Frank family.
Everything will change for the better. That this cruel teacher will end.
enough.
I got this. Wait. I can't. It's stuck.
Gus.
I know.
How did you come up with that?
I don't know. It just came out. I was so angry.
What a monster.
Mom was awful.
Then what happened?
We went to Aunt Frank's house.
Well, you did.
And after that? Oh, we just walked around.
So just before you went to the hospital, there was this... I felt an ache in my hip. So I had a PET scan. And it lit up like a Christmas tree. Granting factory. Hey, listen. Don't you worry about me, Hazel Grace, okay? I'm gonna find a way to hang around here and annoy you for a long time. Suppose you can just forget about this.
Yeah.
Don't just treat me like I'm not dying.
I don't think you're dying, Augustus. You've just got a touch of cancer.
It would be absolutely ludicrous if we just made up right now.
Thank you.
Take my body,
Augustus.
Hazel Grace.
Hi. Oh my god, hi. Hi, I love you. Oh my god.
I'm at the gas station.
You're what?
Something is wrong. You gotta... Can you come and help me? My pack, and they might have lost it or something, or they took it, but I wanted to do something for myself, you know, I wanted to do it myself.
I have to call 911.
No!
I have to.
No!
Hi, 911? We need an ambulance.
My
First Avenue, in a summer. I'm Hazel Grace Lancaster. Please hurry. We're in a silver Jeep at the gas station.
I wish I could say that Augustus Waters kept his sense of humor till the end. And not for a single moment did his courage waver. But that is not what happened.
I'm just gonna hang out for a while, if you don't.
his kid's tough or whatever, but... I always thought I would be a hero. I always thought I'd have a grand story to tell. You know, something they published in all the papers. And... I mean, I was supposed to be special.
You are special.
Yeah, I know, but... You know what I mean?
I do know what you mean, I just don't agree with you. You know, this obsession you have with being remembered...
Mad.
I am mad. I'm mad because I think you're special. Is that not enough? Do you think that the only way to lead a meaningful life is for everyone to remember you? For everyone to love you? Guess what, Gus? This is your life, okay? This is all you get. You get me, and you get your family, and you get this world, and that's it. And if that's not enough for you, then I'm sorry, but it's not nothing. Because I love you. I'm gonna remember you.
I'm sorry. You're right.
I just wish you would be happy with that. Bullshitty conventions of the cancer genre is the convention known as the last good day. When it seems like the inexorable decline is suddenly plateaued, when the pain is just for a minute bearable. The problem, of course, is that there's no way of knowing that your last good day is your last good day. At the time, it's just another decent day.
Good evening, Hazel Grace. Quick question for you. Did you ever write that eulogy I asked you to prepare?
I may have.
Do you think you could find your way down to the literal heart of Jesus in the next few minutes?
Maybe. Is everything okay?
I love you, Hazel Grace.
Can I have the keys?
Oh. Where are you going? Are you inside?
I have to go.
Hazel, you have to remember, you didn't even eat lunch.
I'm just not hungry.
You want a salad or something?
I'm aggressively unhungry.
Hazel, I know Gus is sick, but you gotta take care of yourself.
Mom, this has nothing to do with Gus.
Well, then you've gotta stay healthy. Come on, just eat something, honey.
Stay healthy? Okay, I'm not healthy and I'm gonna die. Do you realize that I'm dying and you're gonna be here and you're not gonna have anyone to look after or hover around and you're not gonna be a mother anymore and I'm sorry, but there's nothing I can do about that, so can I please go?
Hazel,
why would you say
do
that?
Do not say.
Because you said that.
What are you talking about?
In the ICU.
Hazel. That's not the truth. I was wrong. Right? Even if you died.
When?
Even when you die. I'll always be your mother. It's the greatest thing I'll ever be.
That is my biggest fear, Mom. When I am gone, you're not gonna have a life anymore. You're just gonna sit and you're gonna stare at walls, or you're gonna off yourselves, or...
Hazel, honey, we're not gonna do that. Losing you... That is gonna hurt like hell. But you, of all people, know it's possible.
Tell me this.
Wait a
We don't want you to feel abandoned.
Feel abandoned? You guys, this is the best news.
You go.
Straight ahead, yeah. To your left a little bit. Let's see. Yeah. Right. Put your hand out. There's a podium to your right. Yep. Perfect. Beautiful.
Hi.
You're late. How are you doing? You look ravishing, Hazel Grace.
I know. Right?
Tell her, Gus. I wanted to attend my own funeral. I mean, I'm hopeful that I'll be able to attend as a ghost, but... However, just in case it doesn't work out, I decided to plan this pre-funeral. Ready? Augustus Waters was a cocky son of a bitch. But we forgave him. Not because of his superhuman good looks, or because he only got 19 years when he should have gotten way more.
18 years, buddy.
Dude, come on. Really, I'm assuming you have a little more time. You interrupting bastard. Interrupt me in the middle of my eulogy. You're supposed to be dead. But, when the scientists from the future come to my house with robot eyes, and they tell me to try them on, I'm gonna tell those scientists to piss off, cause I don't even wanna see a world without you. I don't wanna see a world without Augustus Waters. Then having made my point, I'll probably put the robot eyes on, cause you know, come on, the robot eyes. Sounds awesome.
Down to you, Hazel Grace.
Augustus Waters was the star-crossed love of my life. Ours is an epic love story, and I probably won't be able to get more than a sentence out without disappearing into a puddle of tears. Like all real love stories, ours will die with us, as it should. You know, I'd kind of hoped that he'd be the one eulogizing me. Because there's really no one else. Likely to get. And God,
Gus. My love. I cannot tell you how thankful I am for our little infinity.
Augustus Waters died 8 days later in the ICU. When the cancer, which was made of him, stopped his heart, which was also made of him. The first things they ask you in the ER is to rate your pain on a scale from 1 to 10. I've been asked this question hundreds of times, and I remember once when I couldn't catch my breath and it felt like my chest was on fire. The nurse asked me to rate the pain. Though I couldn't speak, I held up 9 fingers. Later, when I started feeling better, the nurse came in and she called me a fighter. You know how I know, she said? You called a 10 a 9. But that wasn't the truth. I didn't call it a 9 because I was brave. The reason I called it a 9 was because I was saving my 10. And this was it. This was the great and terrible 10.
Fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Augustus Waters fought hard for many years. His battle was a courageous one. And his strength...
I want to shed on, kid.
Was a source of inspiration for each and every one of us. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, for the life of Augustus Waters.
We need to take a break now.
For his strength and his courage. Lord, we ask that you be with us today. That you be close, that you comfort his friends and family. Thank you for your presence, Lord. All of us, we pray in Jesus' name. Going to hear from Gus's special friend, Hazel Lancaster.
Hazel.
course, but how's it going? There's a beautiful quote in Gus's home that reads, "If you want the rainbow, you have to deal with the rain." Even in his last few days, I didn't believe a word. He was always able to crack a smile. But that's okay. To make you feel better. I knew this was the right thing to do. Funerals, I decided, are not for the dead.
Don't give me up.
how we feel about you. Talking to him at the cemetery, and he said he came all this way to give that letter to you.
Yeah, well, I'm over it. You have no interest in reading another word of that asshole's again.
No, he didn't write it. Gus wrote it.
What?
Apparently Gus wrote something down and then sent it to Van Houten.
But a shitty writer. You're a shitty person, but a good writer. I think we'd make a good team. I don't want to ask you for any favors, but if you have the time, and from what I saw you have plenty, please fix this for me. It's a eulogy for Hazel. She asked me to write one, and I'm trying. I could use a little flair. See, the thing is, we all want to be remembered. But Hazel's different. Hazel knows the truth. She didn't want a million admirers, she just wanted one. And she got it. Maybe she wasn't loved widely, but she was loved deeply. And isn't that more than most of us get? When Hazel was sick, I knew I was dying. But I didn't want to say so. She was in the ICU, and I snuck in for 10 minutes, and I sat with her before I got caught. Her eyes were closed, her skin pale, but her hands were still her hands. Still warm, and her nails were painted this dark blue-black color, and I just held them, and I willed myself to imagine a world without us, and what a worthless world that would be. She's so beautiful. If she's smarter than you, because you know she is. She's funny without ever being mean. I love her. God, I love her. I'm so lucky to love her, Van Houten. You don't get to choose if you get hurt in this world, but you do have a say in who hurts you. I like my choices. I hope she likes hers. Okay, Hazel Grace.
See the stars from America.
chasing too. So open.